Be right back, guys. Let me get settled here. Good morning, good morning. Give me just a few minutes there, guys, just getting set up. Hope you guys are doing all right this morning. Good morning. We are definitely going to talk about that. Because what happened yesterday was pretty much exactly what I thought was going to happen. I went ahead and added CTXR into my live stream because I am about to make a decent sized deposit or investment in this company probably sometime early this upcoming week. Let's let some more people flow up in here real quick. Good morning, guys. If you're in the chat, please like the video. Much appreciated. I know it's Saturday. You guys are probably... There's probably not going to be a lot of people in here, but we're going to talk about some stuff for about an hour. And what's up, Inster, Luna, Brett, good morning. Working on a Saturday. That sucks. At least you're making money, man. At least you're making some money. Guess I'm going to give it just a few more minutes, guys. I'm going to let some more people flood up in here before I start this live stream, really. Got a few things to talk about as far as microvision goes. Citius Pharmaceuticals, we're going to go over price action and, you know, do some DD on this company, some more DD. Talk about what they do, their products, and where I think the share price can go. If you're just joining in, if you could just press that like button real quick, I would really appreciate it. I think I fixed the delay. Guys, give me a thumbs up in the chat if you can hear me right now. I think I fixed the delay that was going on last time. All right, it's a little bit faster than the than it used to be. Citius Pharmaceuticals. It's a good. This is a good company to be in. This is a really nice stock. The chart looks good. We're gonna talk about it here in just a minute. And yeah, just gonna let a few more people get in here before we get going. Once we get about 25 people, I'll start up the DD on this company. Guys, you can share this link in Weeble chat if you don't mind. Maybe in the Microvision section or wherever, whatever platforms you use. Whether it's Stockwits or Reddit or whatever. Reddit's a little bit mad at me now, so I don't know if they're going to come. But, you know, it still helps. Good morning, everybody who is just joining in here. Yeah. Seems like the delay is definitely going to be there. It doesn't seem as bad as it was. There was like three settings. I put it to the fastest one, so we'll see. Oh. It's one of those mornings. Nobody's awake on Saturday morning at 9:30 in the morning. I'm probably only going to stream for about 45 minutes, guys. But we're going to get into this DD on this company, Sidious Pharmaceuticals. This is a company that I am looking into making a sizable investment in this upcoming week, I think. So trying to learn some more about it, what they're trying to do, what they do exactly. Give me one sec, guys. Got a quick phone call. Give me one second. Everyone's still asleep, man. Richard Ireland says, "Is it James? Is it true that Tesla has LiDAR?" I didn't think they used LiDAR, but I don't know. I don't think that Tesla has LiDAR. I think Tesla uses like cameras. Guess we can just Google it real quick. Well, I guess this. I mean. Musk continues to insist that computer vision supported by cameras and radar is the way to go. Electrek reported that just this week, Musk has once again told analysts that Tesla will never use LiDAR. Early on, it seemed the issue with LiDAR was cost. Well, if the issue is cost, then maybe Elon Musk needs to sit his ass down and do some microvision research because they've created a pretty cost-effective product, you know? Fairly cheap compared to all of its competitors, you know. It's fairly cheap. Considering how much a freaking Tesla costs, I mean, I would imagine they could put some LiDAR in it. And even if you have, you know, you're using cameras and radars and stuff, it doesn't hurt to add more technology, you know. Oh my god. What's up, Andrew? Thank you. So far, so good, man. I got up a little bit early today, but you know what? Sometimes it's just like that, man. Good morning to you. Guys, you don't mind helping me out, just maybe copy the link and go to the Weeble chat or wherever you use, whatever platforms you use to talk about stocks. Maybe share the link. We'll try to get some more people in here this early Saturday morning. We're going to talk microvision. We're going to talk about what I thought was going to happen and what basically played out yesterday and how I was fairly close. I was pretty accurate, guys. I told you guys we would probably get up. I was going to imagine we would get up to this 1410. And that's kind of what happened. All right. We did, you know, we didn't make it that quite that far, but we did have happen what I thought was going to happen, which was, you know, we break through this trend line, came all the way down here, bounced off this trend line, which was at the bottom of this consolidation little area that we got going on here, and started making our way up towards this golden zone. And that's pretty much what happened, guys. We ended the day with some buy pressure, so I imagine on Monday, we're probably going to make our way up to the top of this consolidation. So whether we break out or not, I don't know. Whether we break out, I don't know. But that's the way it's looking. It's looking like we're going to. We could just trade sideways again and just, you know, meet over here at this trend line for another touch and then find our way up. But it's looking like we're going to probably break out sometime next week, guys. April's coming up. I cannot imagine how this company would not go up in value. So we have no idea when it's actually going to happen in April, you know, but it is almost April. It is almost April. Good morning to everybody. Just joining in. Thank you for being with me this morning. If you could press that like button, you never have to do it again on this stream, at least. Heather, good morning. Jason, good morning. Jason, that's why I urge people to learn price action. You know, if you know price action, if you know how to read these charts, it kind of alleviates some of the worry. You know, there's not much to worry about, right? We, you know, every time we've touched this trend line, we've made a gigantic move up. So, I mean, history repeats itself and, does it in the markets too. So, you know, you can make an educated, speculatory, is it speculative or speculatory? Either way, you can make a guess it's going to happen again. So every time we've touched this trend line here since this big move, we've had gigantic moves up, all right? And if I bring it even down here a little more, like if I bring this trend line down more, it's going to be the same thing here. So, you know, we had a touch point here, we moved up. Touch point here, moved up. Touch point here, had a gigantic move up to $24. And then, you know, dropped all the way back down below the golden zone. We had a pretty big retracement here, but we did touch this trend line and make our way back up to this 1928. So now we're down here again at the bottom of the trend line and the bottom of this consolidation zone. And so it's more than likely that we're going to find our way back up in this $16, $17 range shortly. It is frustrating, but, you know, you got to remember what you invested in, man. You know, it's pretty important to do that. These red days can suck and they can kind of be depressing, and you know, I know firsthand how it feels to look at your portfolio and see red. But you know, if you made a good investment, you shouldn't have anything to worry about in the long term. So you never actually lose the money until you press sell. You know, it's a pretty basic thing to say, but it is true, and it's actually important that people remember that, because you're never gonna realize the loss unless you press sell. So this stock could go down to $1. If you got $100,000 invested and it goes, then, you know, you're negative, you know, all that money, you don't actually lose it until you press sell. That's a fact. So that's just a fact. Now you can hedge your position. And there's different things you can do. Obviously, if the stock's going down and it's broken levels of support, and, you know, you can hedge your positions. But at the end of the day, the basic concept is just that you don't lose money unless you press sell. All right. So don't realize those losses, especially on this stock. Especially on this stock. Twenty people up in the chat, guys. I appreciate you being here this morning. If you press like on that video, I would appreciate it. Give me a thumbs up in the chat if you're having a good day. I cannot wait for my coffee to get here. Oh my God. I cannot wait. Bring the coffee, Ori, please. She's a trooper, guys. Today is her birthday. Today's my girlfriend's birthday. So shout out to her. She's a great person. And I'm gonna make sure she has a great day. Go take her out for a nice steak dinner tonight. And yeah. April is coming up, guys. April's coming up. So there's not much to worry about with Microvision. I mean, there's just not a logical explanation on why the stock would go down right now. There's just not. It doesn't make any sense in the world. So this market crash right here and this market crash right here, this is all manipulation. Okay, we know that the price does not want to be down here. All right, it's very obvious. It's very obvious. And where we are right now, guys, this is a huge deal. We got two really big things going on in this chart. And, you know, I want you guys, you know, if you don't understand, you know, technical analysis and you don't understand, you know, what all this means, but you're still watching, just know that, you know, these two things I'm going to talk about today are very important as far as the chart goes. Oh, thank you guys so much. So the first thing that's important about this chart, all right, number one, right here, we're consolidating in this area, all right, guys? Let me move these lines. No, I'm not going to move these lines. We are consolidating in this area down here to this basically 1277 and 1412, okay? We're just going to use, and guys, like I said, these lines are very vague, okay? I like to use zones. I'm from Forex, and in Forex, we use zones. We don't use lines, all right? So if I really was doing it, like, you know, some super technical analysis for you guys like I do in my own time, I would do it more like this. But since we're just streaming, I'm just going to do it like pretty vague. But I would do it like this. I do something like this and something like maybe like this. All right. So these are zones. These little gaps are here. These are zones. All right. It opens it up. It creates a little bit more variance in the breakouts and just all this stuff. So I like to use zones. All right. So we're in this zone, the big zone right here. Okay. And you can see price has gone down and touch, gone up and touch, gone down and touch. And now you can imagine it's going to go back up a touch. That's why my price prediction for yesterday was about 14 to 1410. All right, we didn't quite make it up all that way, but we did exactly, literally, I mean, just literally exactly what I said was going to happen. We were going to come down if we broke that trend line, which we did, and we were going to touch the bottom of the trend line here, and make our way off the trend line back up into this golden zone. And the way I knew that was pretty simple, guys. I mean, I don't have a crystal ball, okay? It's pretty simple. It's not that difficult to see what's going on, all right? Hey, I'm gonna let you know right now, Deep Flacone, you're gonna get banned so fast. Like, I will ban you with the quickness. I figured out how to do it, so don't come in here playing games. Don't come in here playing games with me. I will ban you so fast, last warning. Don't come in here playing games with me. All right, so guys, anyways, we bounced off this trend line and we made our way back up towards this golden zone. All right, that's pretty much what I said was going to happen. And we didn't quite get the volume to get pushed up to the top of the zone, but we did have some buy pressure and we did end the day on the hourly chart with some buy pressure. Okay, so that's good. Now I'm going to give him a warning because I've never seen him in here before. So, never seen him in here before. These people are just so stupid. They don't know what they're talking about. It's hilarious. Anyone who thinks anything I did was illegal, just please slap yourself. You're so stupid. You're just dumb. You're just a sheep following some subreddit cult leader, okay? You have no idea what you're talking about. So, last warning, Deep, what's your stupid name? Dev Platt Flecon? Last warning, buddy. So anyways, guys, we made our way back up in the middle of this zone with some buy pressure here on this last candle towards the end of the day. That was good. We didn't quite get as high as I thought, but guys, like I said, we're in this zone right here, okay? If you look left, if you ever want to know what's going to happen in the future or what's going to happen where the price is at now, typically, most times, you just got to look left. So if we're in this zone here and I look left, where's the last time we were in this zone? It was right here. Price does not want to be in this zone. You can just see it. We fell straight through this zone with some momentum, and we came back up in this zone with some momentum and came out. There's not a lot of action up in here, okay? And if I keep looking left, you're going to see the same thing. There's not a lot of action in this area. Just shot straight through it with no problems. So this zone is not somewhere that Microvision's price wants to be, all right? So I can imagine that it's probably going to just go up. There's not a reason for it to go down. This trend line's super respected, all right? Super respected, all right? This trend line is super respected. You can see all the way from the start of this move, it's just been respected the whole entire freaking way, all right? Oh my God, it's been respected the whole way. Every time we've touched it, we have huge moves up, all right? And right now, we're basically out of touch, okay? And it's right before April as well. There's a lot of news around the stock right now, so there's no way it's going to go down. It could, yes, it could. If you go to a higher time frame, or you could kind of say that we're consolidating on a bigger zone somewhere up in here like this, all right, something like that, and we're consolidating in this big area right here. So technically, yes, you could come down if you want to call this consolidation, but I don't think that's going to happen. I do not think that that's going to happen. I just don't. All right. But like I said, price does not want to be in this area. All right, you can see. It's chilling in here now. All right, it's chilling. There's a little bit more action on this side now. But if you look in the past, and I guarantee you, if I keep going back all the way left, if I go to like a monthly chart and I go back all the way to like 2006 or years, a decade ago, the same thing you're gonna find. And I've already done it, and I can tell you straight up that this area right here, there's not a lot of action. Price does not like it in this area. Okay, and we just made a bounce off this trend line, and so I can imagine we're gonna go back up, right, guys? And that's what I think. So we're just going to have to see how it plays out on Monday. But I imagine we're going to be up in this golden zone on Monday. Good morning to you guys. Alex, good morning. Grant, good morning. Good morning to everybody in here. Please press that like button. It helps a lot. And guys, if you haven't subbed to the channel, please do that. You get the notification bell. Hit the notification bell so you know when I go live. I'm going to do a Moonwatch video later. My number 10 Moonwatch video, guys. Number 10. Let's get some thumbs up for that. Number 10 Moonwatch. I took a couple days off making those. Actually took like a week off, but I am gonna do it, and it's really gonna just be the same thing we're talking about here. So if you're in the live stream and you're watching me do this live, there's not gonna be a lot on that video that you're gonna see any different. All right, it's gonna be kind of the same thing. All right, but like I said, there's two main things on this chart right now that we need to focus on. That's number one, the price does not want to be in this area. You can tell, you can just look left and see it, all right? Number two is we made our way back up above the high that closed above the previous high in this downtrend, all right? We had a downtrend right here. Boom, 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 three touch points, okay? One, two, three. And then we came up and we actually closed above the previous high in the downtrend right here. All right, we closed above this one. That was a huge reversal signal, absolutely epic. All right, we thought, I thought we were for sure gonna come close right here, come back down, maybe touch right here and start making like, you know, a higher low from this one and make our way back up towards the top of this trend line and make a higher high. That didn't happen. The market crashed, okay? It took us all the way down to 10-10, and that sucked. That hurt. That was painful, not gonna lie. That was super painful. Grant Smith, yeah, you know, I was gonna start including AMC because I was honestly thinking, I told myself if AMC drops below $10, I was gonna put $5,000 in and just let it ride, and I still might do that. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to really look into AMC. I do think that it's definitely got squeeze potential. That's just a fact. Everybody knows that. But guys, you gotta remember this: the hedgies have unlimited funds. Okay, I don't like that people think that they're gonna run out of money. They're not gonna run out of money. The stock is not worth enough to make a hedge fund go broke. Okay, it's just not. So, you know, it's not going to run out of money. They can keep it at that price as long as they freaking want to. All right. So it's just until they decide to let go of the throat. Right. I don't know. We're going to have to see how it plays out. But I do think it has long term potential. Even if it wasn't a squeeze, even if a squeeze did not happen on AMC, I still think, like, in my heart of hearts, that AMC is a good investment. All right, especially since they are reopening locations. This COVID crap is about to be over, hopefully. And you know, it definitely is a $12 to $15 stock, maybe more, you know, in the long term. And if they open locations and somehow they manage to, you know, survive for real and, you know, open new locations and do some new stuff, maybe with their business model or maybe figure something out, I don't know. I think it's a good long-term investment. All right. RYCEY, good long, basically my savings account. Yeah, man, I've heard a lot about that one. I haven't done too much DD on it, but I've heard a lot about it. Guys, this chat, we're going to focus on CTXR and MVIS. All right, this is a new company that I'm super, super excited about. I really am. I like the chart. I like the setup. I like what they're doing with their company. They did a conference on the 25th, which was Thursday. Yeah, it was Thursday, or maybe it was yesterday. Yesterday or Thursday, but they pretty much showcased their cash cow product, and I'll show you guys what it is. It is called the Mino Lock, all right? Where did this tab go? Here it is. The Mino Lock, all right? What this does, this is a antibiotic lock solution used to treat patients with catheter-related bloodstream infections, CRBSIs, all right? And they're very dangerous, guys. You know, these kill a lot of people when they get them, so... a lot of people that have a CRBSI, 25% of people that even have these catheters get this infection, get an infection, and 10% of the 25% die. Okay, so that's huge. That's a big number. So this company has come in and created this product that can pretty much eliminate all infections. And it's a treatment. It's not a prevention. So it's only two competitors are prevention methods. Okay. This company is actually a treatment for someone who already has the infection. That's huge. All right. They have a patent that locks them in till 2036. So basically they have an uninterrupted market for over a decade. Okay. Almost a decade and a half. Nobody's going to be able to come in here and do anything. They're going to saturate the market with this product, and nobody's going to be able to compete with them. Really. They're in phase 3 trial. They're in phase 3 of this Menolock. They're being streamlined through the FDA. So they've already got the approval. And I think this company is going to see some sales probably by the end of this year. All right. This product is 30% cheaper than any other alternative. And it's going to save the hospitals, the insurance companies. It's going to save them a crap load of money. And it's looking really good. All right. It's looking really good. We'll go in a little more DD on this company and what they do. But, if you guys are interested in looking it up yourself, it's sidiouspharma.com. You can go to the up here and read about the Menolock. This is their cash cow product. All right. This is the product they're going to sell first. That's going to, you know, generate them some money and, for the rest of their research. All right. Anything under $2 is good for CTXR. Anything under $2 is going to be good. All right. We might see a drop off here. It's possible to come back down to this, you know, 180 level, maybe lower, maybe the bottom of this golden zone, this 176, something like that. But, and we could bust through the golden zone and come down here and touch the trend line at 170, or maybe a little lower, 165. But, like I said, it's kind of the same thing as Microvision. This bottom trend line on the big time frame, well, on the hourly time frame, is pretty respected, right? Every time it's touched down here, it's had a move up. All right. Right here, it had a big move up. And like I said, history repeats itself. So if it touches the trend line again, that's going to be a really solid entry point. That's going to be a really solid entry point. 191, that's a good entry. That's a good. You're up a little bit. Guys, don't just follow me blind, okay? Alex Galagos, I would love for you to invest in the company. I haven't made my investment yet, but just do your own research and, you know, don't just follow me blindly, all right? Make sure you do your research. It's very important to know what you're investing in and the risks and all that stuff. So it's important to know that, all right? But it is a very promising company. I mean, they have this whole catheter-related bloodstream infection thing on lockdown, all right? Central venous catheter is, I mean, if you have to have one of these put in, the percentage that you're, I mean, the chance that you're going to get a bloodstream infection from it is 25%. That's very, very high. Okay, so for a company to come in and be able to absolutely, like, just drop that number, that's pretty big, all right? That's pretty big. Now, just know this company has almost no money. They have no sales. All right, they're burning through cash pretty fast. They have about a year left of money, but like I said, they have projections, and they've pretty much stated that the money, they're going to have sales by the end of this year, all right? So they have enough money to last them through 2021, and they're already streamlined through the FDA, so they have that going for them, and product to market speed is going to be hyper fast. All right. So as soon as that's actually done, they're going to get this product to market. All right. They just showcased it yesterday in the Benzinga. I think it was a Benzinga conference. Is that what it's called? So Sidious Pharmaceuticals to highlight its phase 3 clinical trial product, Menolock, at Benzinga Biotech small cap conference on. Thank you. Are you going back? Okay, love you. All right, have a good day. One sec, guys. I'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back. All right, where was I? Oh, yes. Mina Locke. All right. So, yeah, basically, they just showcased this was it March 25th? So Thursday, right? Yeah, Thursday. So that's probably going to bring the share price up on this upcoming week. I imagine it will. All right. This is a very niche company. It's a very niche product, but there's nothing competing with them. There's nothing else on the market that does what they do. All right. So let me pull up my notes real quick, because I had written a lot of notes about this company. You're not going to see these notes. I'm just going to read them to you guys. But basically, so they're in phase 3 testing, fast-tracked by the FDA. And also, it is a micro-cap company, all right, but it has a low float, all right? It has a super low float, this company. Its insider ownership is 22%. Institutional ownership is 14%. And pretty much everything that they have in their pipeline is innovative, is hyper-innovative, and they really have no real competition. They just don't. All right, the Mina Locke study is to be completed by April 2021. So at the end of this upcoming month, the study is just going to be done. Phase 3 will be done in April. So like I said, guys, if you're interested in getting this company, you need to do it before April, because the study is going to be done in April. So I imagine the stock price is going to go up. Mina Locke product is an anti... Okay, well, I already read that. Let me skip that. This is a little bit about the company's financials. So Mina Locke is the cash cow product for this company. It's going to be used to fund the rest of their research. I told you about the insider ownership. There's 125 million outstanding shares. The share float is 67 million, which is really, really low. So any news on this company is it could just make the share price just pop off. It really could. You could see $8, $9, $10 here pretty shortly. Institutional ownership is 14%, and the trading volume is high compared to the shares. So this company has no revenue. Like I told you guys, they have absolutely no revenue. They're burning through their cash faster than they can make it. And if they keep going at this level, or if they keep going at this rate, they will run out of money by the end of the year. But there's got to remember, they're being streamlined through the FDA, and they expect sales by the end of this year. So they're going to be safe, all right? Let's see here. They could do an ATM. They could dilute the shares, but they're not going to do that, because 22% of the company is inside owned, right? So, I mean, insider ownership is 22%. They don't want to dilute the share price. That lowers their net worth. They would never want to do that right now with this stock. It wouldn't make any sense. All right, their main goal is to get product to market. That's the main goal for this company. Let's see. Where was I? Sorry, I was trying to read y'all's comments. My notes. That's right, my notes. Let me finish my notes real quick. All right. So the top institutional holders for this company are Vanguard, Hightower, Argent, Geode, Virtue, WAS, Savvy Advisor Group, Northern Trust, and GSA. The top mutual fund holders are Vanguard and Fidelity. All right. So there's a lot of institutional holders in this company. And obviously, if a company like Vanguard is investing, well, they believe in it. You know what I mean? And they're a pretty big investor in this company. The only competitors that they have are ClearGuard HD. And here's the thing about ClearGuard HD. It only works in hemodialysis, all right? Only in hemodialysis. Mina Locke is used for CVCs, all right? And just know that. Mina Locke is used for any CVCs. ClearGuard only reduces CLABSI up to 63% and only works in hemodialysis. All right, the other quote-unquote competitor, which, like I said, that's kind of the wrong word, because they're not. They're different. These two companies do prevention, and Citius does actual treatment. So there's big difference there. But they released a drug called Defencath, and it is for the prevention of CRBSIs, not treatment, okay? And it only works in hemodialysis, and it's only 71% effective, and it costs like a crap ton more money to do as opposed to just treating the bloodstream itself with the Mina Locke, all right? Mina Locke is a treatment for established infections, okay? Others are meant to prevent an infection from happening. Mina Locke is 30% cheaper, roughly. I think I talked about this. FDA is accelerated into phase 3. It'll be wrapping up by April 2021. Sales by the end of this year, early next year, depending on when the FDA approves it. But it's already being streamlined, so that's going to happen. So I'm just going to read the strengths and weaknesses real quick, and we'll be done with this little note thing, this little note section. The strengths. It's one of a kind. It has a unique market purpose. Number 2, it's cheaper than the alternatives. Number 3, it's safer for the patients. And number 4, this is going to be a huge one. Hospitals and insurance companies will save a lot of money using this as opposed to the other competitors, all right? The weaknesses, the company is tiny and has no partners for distribution to move the product, all right? They're working on that, and they need to step that up, because if they want to get their product to market, well, they're going to have distribution, right? They're low on money. They have a tight budget, about a year left of cash. They have secured work. This is huge, okay? This is not a weakness. I don't know why I have it a weakness. I need to move this back up. But this is actually huge. This is a strength, okay? They have secured worldwide rights, all right? And they hold a patent in the U.S. till 2036. So that basically says, and you know, that they have an uninterrupted market exposure for over a decade, which means they're going to saturate this market before anyone can even compete with them, all right? So they have a unique product, guys. They really do. It looks really, really promising, especially in the, when you look at what a catheter-related bloodstream infection is. You guys can go to this wiki. I'll put the link in the chat for you guys and read about what a catheter-related bloodstream infection is. There you go. This is the wiki for what that is. We're going to talk about MicroVision, guys, here in a minute. Just wanted to tell you, talk a little bit about this company because I'm pretty excited about it. I think this is gonna pop off, and the chart looks good. Guys, they had a really big retracement down here, and it's kind of just bouncing off this golden zone and this golden zone, pretty much, as you can see. So I would imagine we're going to make our way up to this top of this trend line here and at least minimally touch the bottom of this golden zone, this 218. You could day trade this stock pretty successfully, guys. I mean, if you get in right now at 190 and we get up to the top of this trend line and you sell it like 209 or something like that, or 210, you make some money. And if it goes back down, well, you can wait for it to touch down again and make some more money on the way back up. If it breaks out, you can add on to your position. I mean, there's a few things you can do with it, all right? There's a few things you can do with it. Let's read some of these comments. Off topic, check out KIO. Trader finished last 5 minutes with that yesterday before ending with MVIS. Can't wait to see him and TMJ freestyle together. Oh, nice, man. Yeah. We were supposed to do something yesterday or the day before. Just didn't happen. Hopefully, we can do something this upcoming week. I like that guy a lot. And I would like to do something with him like that. That'd be cool. Oh, my God, this cat. Get out of here. I swear this cat just... Wow. What a psychopath. This cat is a legitimate psycho. Let's see here. Might throw a couple $100 to CTXR. Yeah. I think we talked about that, Alex. It's definitely a good time to do it. All right, guys. So CTXR looking good on the chart. It looks like a really good setup. Looks very similar to MicroVision. All right, you can see here. This is MicroVision, and this is CTXR. It looks pretty similar. All right, pretty similar. MicroVision is just hanging out in this area. We need MicroVision to make it out of this golden zone right here. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm ready for them to just announce some news, and it's been a rough month or two, you know? We've had a big jump up and a huge breakdown. Shorts made a lot of money going down all the way to 10.10. They made a crap ton of money. They really did. Thirty people up in the chat, guys. If you could like the video, I would appreciate it. If you're new to the channel, guys, press the sub button. You can get those notifications when I go live. Mainly MicroVision right now, but I'm going to add this into my portfolio here pretty soon. And might also throw some AMC in there too, guys. I had a $10,000 AMC investment. If you guys didn't know, I liquidated that a couple weeks back, maybe like a month ago. And I was just tired of waiting, to be honest. And I wanted to get in MicroVision. I wanted to add on to my position, so that's what I did. But I might put $5,000 into AMC in the coming days. We're gonna see. I got about $20,000 to play with right now, so I'm either gonna put, you know, 10 more in MicroVision and maybe split 5 and 5 between AMC and this other company, CTXR. I'm not really sure yet. I'm still trying to figure it out what the best move is for me. Inster says, what is my MVIS position? I own 2,100 shares, and my average cost is about $11.50, I think. So 2,100 shares, average cost $11.50. Roughly. I don't know how accurate that is, because I have a separate account on Cash App that I have like 6,000 of MicroVision in. So I mean, the average may be a little different. It might be a little, there might be some variance in my average. Yeah, eyes in the sky. I think I probably will, to be honest. It is BAFF. That is a fact. That is a fact. And I like the setup here, you know. We're looking good. As long as we respect this trend line, guys, we're going to be all right. All right. We're going to be all right. April's coming up. I don't see how the stock could go down. I just don't see how it's possible. The only way it's going to go down is through manipulation, okay? That's the only way. It's not going to go down because retail traders are selling. That is so dumb, and it just makes no sense, all right? This stock price is not going to go down because retail traders are selling their shares. That's just not going to happen. It doesn't make sense. So if we do go down and we bust below this trend line, it's going to be from manipulation. I just don't know how they get away with it. It's just total BS, and I absolutely hate it and despise it, but what can we do about it, you know? Greg Coat, good morning, man. How you doing? Thank you for coming by this morning, Saturday morning. I couldn't stay away. I just couldn't stay away. I had to get on here and do something. At this point, I just feel like I'm not doing anything right if I don't get on here and at least do a stream for like an hour or so. Anthony J, good morning. How are you? They're shorting it pretty hard. I think they're 60% short right now on Microvision. Absolutely ridiculous. Trying to create that phantom premium. That's what they're trying to do with Microvision. If you guys don't know what a phantom premium is, type it in Google. Get a quick recap of it. But that's what they're doing. They're shorting the crap out of it. So they can get down and dirty, get a better entry, make more money on the way up. They know it's going up. But, you know, if I was a hedge fund and I wanted to make money in a stock, I would just short attack the stock until it's super low, and then I'd put my money in and watch it go up and watch my bank account get bigger. Yeah, for sure. For sure there's squeeze potential of 100%. As of March 25th, there's 2.9 million in short volume. 67% shorted. 67%, guys. I want you to think about that number. And Brett, I want to shout out to Brett for throwing this up. I appreciate the numbers there, Brett. And that's exactly why the price is down, all right? Exactly why the price is down. This company, Microvision, is 67% shorted. That's freaking insane. That's huge. That is absolutely huge. 67%. That's insane, guys. The squeeze potential is absolutely awesome for this stock. Just hold your shares and we're going to go up. And like I said, it's the same concept with AMC and GME, okay, guys? But the thing is, AMC and GME are different because, number one, they don't have products coming out that are going to skyrocket the share price alone, right? They don't have that. People are bag holding AMC and GME, hoping for a squeeze. But there's no real reason the stock price is going to go up other than the fact if the shorts don't cover. That's it. Microvision's a lot different. They actually have something that could change the freaking world. We all know that. All right. They're LiDAR vertical. They're AR vertical. There's a lot of things that Microvision are doing that is going to raise the share price organically and naturally. Okay. If you add a squeeze in there, well, it just makes it even better. All right. He's... pretty much, Greg. I mean, yeah, man. I mean, I'm not a financial advisor. Don't, you know, I'm just a dude that trades stocks, okay? Don't take what I say with a grain of salt. But 67% short, are you freaking kidding me? That's huge. That's absolutely, like, colossal. The short interest on this stock is out of this world, all right? So they're trying to short attack the stock. They want to bring the price down as low as they can so they can get a better entry point. And they know it's going up. So that's exactly what I would do if I was trying to be an a-hole and short attack a stock and make a bunch of money on it because I know it's going up. That's what I would do. I would make it seem like the stock is tanking. All right. I just would. And then I would buy it right before it took off. That's exactly what I would do. So that's what they're doing. That's exactly what they're doing with Microvision. 67% short. That's crazy. Absolutely insane. Guys, if you're diamond hands with Microvision, let's get some diamonds in the chat. Let's get some diamonds up in the chat. Or mangoes. Mangoes or diamonds. Oh, that's a lemon. I said mango. Oh my God. That's funny. You guys can do better than that. Put some diamonds in the chat. What are you guys doing? Spam it. Let's go. Guys, if you're just joining the video, please press that like button. We got 40 people in here. Go ahead and smash that like button real quick for me. Would really appreciate it. I guess not. At first sight, it looked like a mango. I swear it did. It looked like a mango, but it's not. Mike P., good morning. Happy Saturday to you too, man. Oh, mangoes are so good. My favorite fruit, hands down. You'd think I would know what it looked like. You'd think I would know what a mango looked like, considering it's my favorite fruit. At this point, I think my cat just likes getting squirted in the face. Like, I just think he likes it. This is no longer effective. I'm going to have to, like, bust out something else to, like, punish him with. Because at this point, he just likes getting squirted in the face. It's the weirdest thing. This does nothing. I need to change it up. Mike Rowe Vision. What a great stock we're in, guys. See if there's any news on MVI. I don't think there is. I don't think there's any other news. Guys, we did just get a patent. We did just get a new patent the other day. Yeah, we did just acquire a new patent. So that's good news. We had the retirement, quote unquote, of board member Yaolong Farhi. This guy owns at least on a bare minimum 10 million shares, guys. 10 million shares, all right? Think about that number. This guy owns 10 million shares of Microvision. And on his outing speech, his little paragraph that he put, the very last sentence said, I'm still excited for the future of this company, all right? If I own 10 million shares and I'm excited for the future of the company, I'm thinking I'm going to probably make some money. You know what I mean? That's a freaking lot of shares. That guy's going to make hundreds of millions of dollars off this company. There's the diamonds. Thank you, Charles. Mike B said, should I keep my MVIS 250,000 shares at 130? Oh, man. Are you showing off, Mike B? I'm jealous. Of course you should keep them, man. What the heck? Oh, my God. Guys, Mike's buying all of us Teslas, all right? Mike, you're locked in on that. I want a Tesla when Microvision sells at 100 a share. All right. I'm going to give you my Facebook, and we'll make it happen. It's just about 100K, all right? It's nothing to compare to what you're going to make off that. Greg just wants a Honda. All right, you know what? Greg gets a Honda, and the rest of us get Teslas, all right? Thank you, Mike B. Oh, Anthony wants a 911 Turbo. All right, well, there's going to be some variants in the cars, Mike B, but we're all going to appreciate you very much when you get filthy freaking rich and hook us all up. Yeah, Microsoft basically made a patent that uses it, that is useless without MVIS. That's true. And, you know, I don't think that they can even do the HoloLens without Microvision. How can they even evolve the HoloLens without Microvision? Someone's already broken the product down and found all the Microvision technology in there. I mean, unless they're going to start brand new with another company, I don't know. I don't see how they do that, though. Jamie Johnson, what's up? Good morning. My Monday prediction is going to be what my yesterday prediction was. All right, we're going to be up in this 1410. Guys, my prediction was on Friday in the morning that we would probably break the trend line. Okay, we'd break this trend line, and we'd come down and touch the trend line right here and make our way back up, all right? And I know that because, well, I thought I knew that because that was my prediction, because every other time we've touched this trend line, we've had a huge move up, all right? It's super respected. This is a hyper-respected trend line since the beginning of this move. I could pull it back even further down here, and it's still respected, all right? Every time we've touched this trend line, we've shot to the freaking moon, all right? Not to mention right here, we did make a higher high as opposed to this one. We did not close, but we did go up and go to the top of this trend line and go higher than this higher high, which closed above the previous high in the downtrend right here. All right. So that's a really huge deal. That's telling me that this price wants to be up here. All right, guys, if you look left where we are right now, there's not a lot of action in this area. All right. That's for a reason. Okay. Price does not want to be where it's at right now. It's very obvious. Alex says 12-10. I don't know. I don't think 12-10. I still think I'm going to still call out 14-10. That's my call out for Monday. At least on a bare minimum. I think we'll for sure be up here above 410, but I think I'm going to, I don't know. I'm actually not going to say 410 because I know we're going to be above 410. We're not just going to test the top of the bottom of this golden zone and come back down. We already have two touch points, guys. All right. We already have two touch points on this trend line. One, two. All right. I don't think we're going to see a third one. It doesn't really make sense. We could, but I don't think we're going to. We left the day with some momentum, so we're probably going to be up in this golden zone. What we need to have happen, we need to break through this golden zone. All right. We need to bust through it. And guys, we were consolidating here in this area, in this golden zone. You can see it right here. So we could come up in here and hang out. But what we want to see happen is go through this golden zone, maybe retest it and close above it. So we need to close above 14, basically 1465. If we can close above 1465 on Monday, there's not much stopping us from getting back up here. All right, there's just not. There's a few walls. There's going to be some hurdles. It's not going to be easy. But there's not a lot stopping us, all right? This was market crash. This is just manipulation. Price was consolidating up in here, you know, and this was just the market crashing, guys. So consolidating around this up in here, up, down, up, down, up, down, right around in here. This was the market crash with this huge candle. It was just a bunch of BS, illegal manipulation. But hey, what can we do about it, right? What can we do about it? So I think we're going to make our way at least back up in this consolidation zone. I think Price, honest to God, I mean, it just really seems like Price wants to be. You can see it floating over here too. Same thing. Up, down, right here in this big zone in between 1867 and 1562, basically. Right? All right. So, I mean, I think we're going to be back up in here pretty soon. I can't see why we wouldn't. April's coming up. This wouldn't make any sense. The squeeze potential is huge. The squeeze potential is huge. 67% short on the stock. That is a big deal. You want to know why all this is happening? There's a huge short interest on this stock right now, guys. All right. Oh, Anthony, we could take a sideways week. I'll take a sideways week over a negative week any day. It's not very fun, but, you know, sideways just means there's pressure being built up. You know, that's actually not a bad thing. We need pressure. We need the stock. We need the pressure to build so we can have a big boom to the upside. That's what we need. Definitely at a discount right now, for sure. $13.45, that's a mega discount. This stock is so undervalued, it's not even funny. This stock is so undervalued right now. It really is. Just reading through y'all's comments. Guys, if you haven't joined the Discord, hop up in the Discord. We got a cool little community building in here. Pretty cool. Give you guys a link real fast. Hey, Kat, can you stop? Thank you. Oh, my God. There we go. Who is iBorrow? I don't know who that is. It took out what? 550,000 shares? Greg Coate says, how do you feel about Robinhood? I freaking hate Robinhood. I love the app. I love the interface. It's just such a great interface. But the CEO is a scumbag. And they're just scumbags for doing what they did, so I can't respect them at all. I'll never use them again, honestly. But, you know, I can't say I won't invest in them. I can't say that. If they IPO and, you know, it looks good, I might throw some money in it. I don't know. I know the millennial trader The millennial trader is going to absolutely adore Robinhood, no matter what they do. All right, they just are. So when you look at it like that, it's definitely a spot where we can make money off them. You know, Coinbase is in the same category. I'm really waiting for Coinbase. I'm probably going to put a. I'm hoping that Microvision goes up really quick so I can pull some of that out, and we can hit my target, and I can have some cash for the Coinbase IPO. I think that's going to be a very, very, very big IPO. And I would love to just be able to put 50K in that, to be honest. Mike B says Tesla's it is. He's holding. All right, Mike B. Thumbs up for Mike B. I'm going to hold you to it, Mike B. When this share price goes to 180 bucks, I'm going to be hitting you up, bro. Look for the message. I'm going to say, Mike B., go ahead and book me my plane ticket wherever you are. I'm going to take you out for a steak dinner, and then we were going to go Tesla shopping in the morning. Guys, have you seen the new Tesla? It's freaking sick, man. Joe Rogan bought a Tesla. Which one was it? Yeah, I was watching a video on it the other day. Oh, yeah, the P100 DL. Jeez. This car is freaking sweet, man. Wait, that's not it. Which Tesla did he buy? Guys, if you haven't watched the videos on Tesla, have you watched the videos where the car goes like 0 to 60 in like a freaking millisecond? I mean, it looks like there was a video that where a guy has one of the new Teslas, and he takes his friends and family and on like little rides and stuff, and what he'll do is he'll scare them. So he'll stop the car like a red light, and then when the red light turns green, he takes off. They look like they're on a freaking rocket ship, man. Their heads fly back. They just look like they're just literally flying through the stratosphere. It's absolutely insane. The battery in that thing is, I don't know the technology behind Tesla. I haven't done too much research. I don't know really what gives it that horsepower. But man, those things are fast, and the torque is just freaking insane. It's just absolutely insane. It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy. But yeah, guys, like I said, I think we're probably going to be up in this golden zone on Monday. Highly, highly, highly suspicious of two touch points right here. And we have an upwards momentum on the last candle with some wick. It's very suspect. All right. So I would imagine we're going to be up in the middle of this golden zone somewhere right here. We got some resistance right here. All right. Right in the middle of this golden zone, basically about 1420, 1418, something like that. 18, 19, 20, something like that. But there's some resistance right here. So I would imagine we're gonna make our way up through and at least touch this. So I'm going to go ahead and probably tell you guys that I think my end of the day on Monday is going to be somewhere up in here. All right. I'm not exactly sure. I don't know if we'll break through the resistance or not. Volume's been kind of low lately. But I'm going to go ahead and give this a 14. I don't know. What can I say? I mean, it wouldn't be that hard to break through this. There's not much. Excuse me. There's not much. I'm burping in the mic. I'm sorry. This is coffee. I take that back. This is actually a pretty big line of resistance. We got a lot of touch points right here. We got some action right here. We got some action right here. We got some action right here. And we obviously have action right here. So we have all this. If we can break through this 1420, there's not much stopping us going up here. I'll tell you that much. 1420 to like 1560, there's like nothing. There's almost nothing. I mean, there's a few small walls. There's one right here. Around 1508. All right, there's a couple small walls, but if we break through this 1420, you know, 1560 on our way back to 16 is not going to be that hard. I don't think. Oh, this is a. Can there be up to four? There can be up to four. Pancake induction motor that generates the torque. Okay. Ashay Patel, thank you for the question. Hopefully you've subscribed to the channel and liked the video. I'll answer your question, though. How they're manipulated, they have a 60, what was it, 67? It was 67. As of the 25th of March, they have a 67.39 short interest on there, okay? I mean, the percentage of the volume shorted is 67.39%. That is freaking huge. 67%. That's crazy. 67% is just absolutely insane, all right? It's market manipulation at its finest. It's so obvious. It's very obvious. So, I mean, basically, that's your answer. I mean, how is it manipulated? They're short attacking the stock. They're short attacking the stock so they can get in at a lower price. So when the price goes up, they make more money. All right, but they make money at all angles, every which way, left, right, up, down. They make money every way. They're like the cruise ship. They're making the waves, and we're just on the surfboard behind riding them. Straight up. Thank you very much, Ashley. Is it Ashkay? Ashkay. Akshay. Sorry about that. It is just a fire sale. That's a fact. That's a fact, man. Or if you're a woman, I'm sorry. I don't know. I'm sorry about that. But it is a fire sale right now, guys. And I would get in while you can. I think if you got into this trend line, man, you got a good deal. Because I don't think, I mean, like I said, we could continue riding up this trend line, but it's very suspect. We already have two touch points back here. We only had one touch point here, and then up here was a little bit higher. This wasn't a touch point, but I mean, history does repeat itself, guys, all right? So, I mean, if we're bouncing off this trend line, you can imagine we're probably going to go up, all right? And there's not much stopping us, you know, getting up here to this 1510. We got to break through this little wall right here, this middle of this golden zone. But other than that, I mean, April's coming up, guys. It's going to shoot us through all that crap. It really is. Why don't you guys tell me what you think we're going to be at? Why don't you guys tell me in the chat where you think we're going to be at the end of Monday? What's your end of the day target on Monday? What do you guys think? Whether you're guessing, whether you're using charting, whatever. What do you think Monday is going to be at on Monday? At the bell at the end of the day, what do you think the price is going to be at? I'd like to know. Let me know in the chat. Spike Owen says 16.5. That would be epic. That would be epic. $16.07, $14.45, $14.61. Well, the good news is y'all think it's going to be above 14, so that's good. Anything above 14 is going to be a win, guys. Let me say that again. Anything above 14 is going to be a win. Because like I said, these lines are kind of vague, all right? I like to use zones. So if I'm going to use a zone, I'm going to use it from the... let me just do all this again. I'm going to show you guys how I do these zones. So I would do it from like the top of the highest wick down to the base of the candles right here. So this would be like a zone. All right, same thing here. Somewhere like, you know, maybe here to like here. All right, so instead of using just one line, I like to use zones. It leaves a little bit of variance and some wiggle room, okay? Anything over $14 is going to be a win, though, guys. All right, because that's going to put us up at the back of this consolidation zone and, you know, towards the top. And hopefully we have enough volume to break out and go to the top. I think April's going to be huge for us, guys. I really do. Mike B, I'm holding you to it, man. Don't be playing with me, Mike. Mike, don't be playing with me, man. I'm going to be real sad if this hits like $160 and I hit you up and you're like, oh, who are you? But yeah, man, you got a really sick entry. That's insane. I hope you hold strong. That's life-changing. I don't know what your financial situation is, but if you're telling the truth, which I believe you, and you really have that entry point with all those stocks, with all those shares, man, you are about to make a freaking killing. You've already made a killing. That's crazy. What a nasty, nasty entry point. So sick. Let's throw a little pitchfork on here. Where's my pitchfork? If I do this move to this move to this move. All right, we want price to be kind of interacting with this middle line, all right? So I would imagine, I mean, usually that it kind of does follow this middle line. So you can imagine, I mean, we're going to be back up in this 1770 at some point, and we're going to be back in this consolidation area. We really, 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 I think you guys underestimate this level, but, you know, I say it all the time in my videos, and I bring it up so much, all right? I bring it up so much, all right? This 1920 close right here, if we ever close above this, which we're going to, it's not if, it's when. When we close above this, you're going to see this stock price freaking skyrocket, all right? You're going to see it skyrocket. And let me tell you why, all right? And like I said, this is just a huge deal. And, you know, guys, this is my opinion. Everybody does their charting different. Everyone has their own angles and stuff like that and, you know, their way of doing things, all right? And I'm just going based off what I know and how I've been taught and just what I know, okay? This is a huge level because there was this is a 10-year all-time high, guys. Okay, think about this. For almost 11 years, a little longer probably, this is basically an all-time high. We're going to just call it an all-time high. Right? It's not the all-time high, but we're going to call it an all-time high. This high right here, 2420, okay, was huge. This move to here was absolutely huge, all right? Then we had this downtrend happen here, okay? We had this downtrend, three touch points, boom, 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 all right? And then we had it literally just reversed, okay? We broke up through the trend line with some momentum, and we ended up closing above where this one is right here, as you guys can see, all right? This close was higher than this one. So this to me said, downtrend stopped, and now we're going to make our way back up because this is just huge. Look at this candle, all right? It was an orange candle. We closed lower, but it did make its way up here higher, okay? So that's a big deal. That's a really big deal. This is where the market crashed the first time, okay? It brought us down to this 1010. We kind of made our way back up, you know, 1856, 1860, something like that, and kind of consolidated here for, you know, a couple days or whatever. What is this? March 15th all the way to March 22nd, so like a week, basically. And it brought us up to this 1930, basically, 19, what is it? 1930, basically, which if we had just been able to close above this, guys, that would have been so awesome. That would have been just so awesome. But we didn't, so we didn't close above it. But if we ever close, or when we close above this 1920, that's when you're going to see FOMO kick in. That's when you're going to see this stock just skyrocket because there's nothing stopping us going all the way back up to this ATH. There's just no walls. There's no stable walls in here, all right? There's like a couple hiccups, maybe like right here at this $21 range. But after that, there's nothing. There's absolutely nothing. So you're going to see the stock skyrocket when we get above 1925, all right? That's just, I almost can guarantee it. Almost can just guarantee it, all right? 1920 close, plus 1920 close, we're going to skyrocket. Microvision is definitely going to the moon. I can't imagine this stock going any lower. I just can't, guys. I'm huge on technical analysis. I've been doing it for years. And I just, you know, from what I'm seeing, and guys, like I said, take what I say with a grain of salt, all right? I am new to stocks. Just keep that in mind, all right? I've been doing stocks for about a year, okay? But I've been doing Forex for like 5 years, all right? So just keep that in mind. I'm semi-new to stocks, but everything seems to play out the exact same way. I mean, it's just much slower. All right, currency pairs are fluctuating at a very high rate, a very high volume, all right? They're up and down insane amounts very quickly, okay? So it's a little bit different, but the price action is still the same. The reversal signals are still the same. The golden zones are still the same. Everything is still the same. It's just at a slower pace, all right? So there's not much difference in it, you know, other than news affects stock a little more. You know, there's a few more factors that come into play in stocks. You know, obviously what the company does, what their products are, what their technology is, stuff like that. You know, but other than that, the price action is very similar. All right. So, and like I said, I chart every single day. I go over this stuff every single day. And from what I can see, it's very, very similar to Forex. But yeah, guys, I can't imagine the stock going down. Eyes in the Sky says it should be a $60 stock right now. I don't know about that. I don't know if this is a $60 stock right now. They don't have a product out, so we got to keep that in mind, guys. We got to keep that in mind. I know we all love Microvision, and we all want to see the stock go up, obviously. But you got to keep this in mind. They don't have a product really yet, okay? They do have a product. They are getting some royalties from Microsoft for their projectors, but they don't have an actual product to market yet. So I think it's on the way. I think if I had to say a fair market value right now for this stock without product to market, oh my God. Give me 1 second, guys. I gotta calm this cat down. 1 second. All right, guys, I'm back. Anyways, like I was saying, we don't have a product to market yet, but April's coming up, so we're going to have to just see. I think if I were to give this stock, if I were to give Microvision a fair value right now, I would probably put it somewhere, you know, between $25 and $33. That's my opinion, you know, and that's just based off all their verticals and stuff like that. And we're on our way back there. We should have been there already if the markets didn't crash, right, and this wasn't being short attacked to hell. We would be there already. We have a bunch of patents, guys. We just got a new patent, so they're on the way. They're doing the right things. Guys, welcome to the channel. Thank you for joining me this morning. If you haven't subbed to the channel, I would really appreciate that. I'm pretty close to the 1,000 sub mark. I haven't really been keeping up with it. I don't know what I'm at right now. We had a little hiccup the other day, but, you know, that's water under the bridge. Let's see here. We got 947 subs, guys. We need just a few more to hit that 1,000. That's going to be a very, very big day for me. I'm very proud of myself. You know, guys, I'm new to making these YouTube videos. I'm new to making videos in general. And, you know, I don't know if I'm doing a good job or not. I'm trying my best here. So hopefully I'm bringing something to the table, something of value for you guys. We got a nice community building here. And I like what's going on. I really do. So thumbs up for the YouTube channel, guys. Thumbs up for the YouTube channel. I really appreciate it. And I appreciate you guys. I really do. You guys make this so much fun. And, you know, I really like getting on here and talking to you guys about this stock. Super, super fun. Spike Owens, welcome. I don't think I've seen you in here before, Spike. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for joining me this morning. Greg Coat, I think, swing trading is kind of when you hold for longer. So, I mean, yeah, I guess you could swing trade the stock for a couple weeks. Yeah, you could. I would definitely, if you want to day trade this stock, you could just make it. I mean, some days I look at this chart and I look at the price action. And I'm just so mad at myself that I'm not day trading it. You know, I'm just really, some days it's bad. You know, I wish I was day trading this stock because I would just be making a freaking killing, man. Making a killing. Seriously, look at this breakout. Came up right here with this crazy, look, this is what we need to have happen, okay? Look at this momentum right here. This momentum in this area. We're in this area right here. Okay, the same area we busted through. Price does not want to be in here, guys. History repeats itself. Price does not want to be in here. You guys watching this? Thumbs up if you're watching this, all right? I want you guys to look at this. It's really important. Price does not want to be in this range. It doesn't. We busted through this zone like nobody's business. There is literally no action here in this area. In here, we busted down through it. There's not much action in this area. Then we busted back up through it. There's just no action in this area. So right now, we're consolidating in the area, which is kind of, you know, that's not the case in the history. So I would imagine we're just going to go up through the top. That's just, it just seems logical, all right? Price does not want to be in here. We want this to happen. We want to come up to the top of the zone the same way this one did. We want just a big candle pushing us up to the top, have this breakout, have the retest. All right, that's called The Last Kiss. Guys, go ahead and read Naked Forex. That's a good book. I learned so much from that book in Forex. It's really mainly based on Forex, but the price action thing is the same. The Last Kiss, look it up. We busted through, we broke out, we came back down, we retested the zone, and that's when we had our move up. That's standard. This is so freaking cookie cutter. It's not even funny. I'm gonna show this to you guys. I'm gonna show you this. I'm just gonna type in Last Kiss Forex, and I'm gonna show you a couple images of what a Last Kiss is, all right? Of what a Last Kiss is. Hopefully I can find one in here. All right, same right here. Check this out. So this is what we want to have happen. So we have our zone right here, okay? I'm gonna keep going back and forth. I want you guys to watch this, all right? I'm gonna prove you something. So we're in the zone. Let's pretend this is the zone, all right? Right here, this is the zone, and this is the zone. All right, so on this chart, what happened? We were in the zone, we came down, we came back up, kind of consolidating. We had this huge candle right here, push us through, and we broke out. Now look at this. Had this huge candle right here. You see this? I can't make this stuff up. Guys, I can't make this crap up. I can't make it up. We had this huge candle right here. We came through. We broke out. We broke out to the top. All right. Right here, we have a huge candle. We came out. We broke out to the top. Then we had a top off here. We came back down to the zone, retested. We retested right here, and that's when we had the big move up. Same thing. Big candle, broke out, came back down, retested for a little bit, and then we had the big move up. You can't make this up. That's called The Last Kiss, all right? That stuff is very, very, very powerful. Okay, so if you're day trading, if you want to day trade this stock and you get these breakouts, you get a breakout to the top, you come back down, more than likely, in Forex, I think the number was like 83% of the time or something like that. If a currency pair on an hourly chart, if it breaks out like this, comes back down and tests the zone, you want to get in right there and take your pips up here, all right? That's just what happens. It happens so freaking often. It's not even funny. It's like taking candy from a baby, guys. It really is. If you just follow The Last Kiss, and it's like taking candy from a baby. Now, in stocks, I don't know if the number's the same, but I'm telling you right now that the price action is the exact same. Look at it. I mean, seriously, look at this. We had this huge candle in the zone, brought us up, came back down, retested, and then we had a huge freaking move up all the way from, what is this, almost a $5 increase. Like, that's insane on a stock. That's crazy. So this Last Kiss would have got you stupid paid. And you see it here, big candle in the zone, pushed you up, retest, and had a big move up there. I mean, you can't make this up, guys. You can't make that up. All right, so that's what we need to have happen here. We on this side, the same thing. We came down, we found some support. All right, we tested twice right here. So I imagine, you know, we're gonna go back up. Hopefully we break through, and we don't need The Last Kiss, but it'd be nice to get The Last Kiss, have it retest the zone, and you know, then you're gonna see that up movement up to like $16, something like that, maybe like $15.50, somewhere up in there. Let's see here. Good morning, everybody. Guys, just in case you see a troll in here, let me know who they are. I haven't really scrolled up and read through all this yet, but I imagine we might have some Reddit backlash, possibly. So if any of those clowns come up in here and say something crazy, just send me a DM and let me know, because I haven't read through all this yet. And I'll make sure to add them to the list. But so far, so good. So far, so good. All right, guys. 38 people in the chat. If you guys could like the video, I'd really appreciate it. I'm trying my best here, you know, to give you guys some price action information. Like I said, guys, yesterday my price target was $14.10. Between $14 and $14.10, which is the top of this consolidation zone. We came down, we tested, and then, like I said, we came right off this big trend line. I'll draw this in for you. I can't make this stuff up, all right? You can't make this up. Look at this trend line here. I'm just going to do it a very quick way. I'm not gonna like be too accurate with it, but you can see. All right, so this trend line is super respected. All right, it has not ever broken through it, not one time on the big move, not once since since December 20, guys. Since December 20, I could pull this trend line all the way down here, okay? And we've never broken below it, ever. All right, this is kind of vague. I could make it a little tighter, but you still get the point. Touch the trend line, big move up. Touch the trend line, big move up. Touch the trend line, big move up. Touch the trend line, huge move up. Touch the trend line, what's going to happen? Are we just going to all of a sudden touch it and break down to the low side? It doesn't make sense. It's not logical. Price action wise, it is completely asinine to think that the stock is just going to tank below the trend line. We've been holding this trend line super strong since freaking December 2020, guys. That's huge. That's like months and months and months of never breaking below this trend line. Why would it just right before April, right before their big debut, right before all this stuff is about to happen, why would it break below it now? It doesn't make sense, guys. It does not make sense. You say all charts are the same. I'm not sure what you mean, Greg. What do you mean? What do you mean? Market is red. Is it realistic that it will break trend line? No. No, it's not. Red does not mean it's going to break below a super respected trend line. It just doesn't. Now, trade sideways? Yeah. We could definitely trade sideways. But, I mean, like I said, we haven't broken this trend line since, you know, for like almost 4 months. Why would it just all of a sudden break below and come back down lower than this trend line? It doesn't make any sense at all, even at this 10-10. The 10-10, guys, imagine all this wasn't here, okay? Imagine all this wasn't here and, you know, I had this trend line drawn in. We had this huge drop off, 10-10, bounced straight off this trend line like a freaking basketball and made a big move up. All right, this trend line is super, super respected. It just is. You can see it right here with your eyes. You can see it. It's super respected. I can't imagine we're going to go lower than it. I mean, we could technically break down below this trend line here and come down and kind of test here. And a lot of people might argue, or not a lot of people, but one could argue that this is consolidation right here. All right. Something like, you know, I want to say maybe like this. All right. This was market crash. We only went this low because of the market crash, right? So I'm just going to say this. One could say this is consolidation, all right? Because, you know, we're down, we're up, down, up, down, up, all in this big zone. All right. So, I mean, technically, and I guess I could put it here. I could put it here. But we don't have any touch points down here. There's only one touch point at this level. Most of the consolidation was happening up here, all right? This was market crash, guys. This whole move right here, this whole freaking thing, this was that first crash, all right? So if that crash didn't happen, we would have just made up here, came in, you know, we would be consolidating between 1420 and 1920, all right? We just would. And you can see it here. The price is just consolidating in this big area, all right? This was the market crash. This was another market crash. So the only reason we're even below this yellow line right here is because the market's been crashed. That's it. Otherwise, we'd be up in this consolidation zone, probably hovering between, you know, $16, $17, $18. Alex says the LiDAR demo is private. Yeah, guys, just know that. The LiDAR demo is not for the public, all right? We're not even going to get the benchmark data. So just remember that. When you got people up in here and anywhere really, but if you see anywhere someone say, oh well, Luminar's technology is better than Microvision's and the data speaks for itself, it's like, dude, how can you even make the claim? There's no way you would know that. You don't have any information on the A sample. You don't have the benchmark data. You don't have anything. How can you say that, right? So the only one who's going to be able to know that information are inside people. There's no way we would ever know that. It could or it couldn't be. All right, I'm not going to lie to you guys. Like, maybe it is, but you don't know that for sure. You don't know that. So there's no way to know. Okay, we're not going to get the benchmark data. We're not going to get any information on the demo. That's just going to be private for the companies that are looking to purchase the vertical or the company, all right? And I guarantee you they're going to have an NDA, so that's obvious. Guys, if you could press that sub button if you're in here and you have not subscribed to the channel and you like what I'm doing, please press that sub button. It helps a lot. I'm trying to get to 1,000. We're almost there, man. We're so close. Oh my God. We're so close. Almost 1,000. That's crazy. CTXR is another one, guys. This is another good company to be in right now. All right. This company's doing really, really solid things. Super low float. Micro cap. Any news could make this stock just freaking pop off. I haven't read about that ship too much, guys. I don't watch the news. I don't watch the news. There's no reason. The whole world is a stage. You know, I constantly have my tinfoil hat on, but you know what? The whole world is a stage. Everything is just controlled at this point, and it's all fear-mongering. It all has agenda. Nothing happens organically anymore. It's just all agenda-based. So anything I see on the news, I know there's an agenda behind it, so I just stay away from it. I live my life, you know what I mean? I don't let actors on a TV tell me how to live my life or how to feel or think. You know what I'm saying? If something happens, okay. But I still believe it's all controlled. The world is a literal stage. Allegedly, Rocket Man, allegedly. Who knows, though, you know what I mean? I, like I said, I don't really keep up with it, so I have no idea what really is happening. I think they did a reverse split, yeah. Spike, I'm pretty sure they did a reverse split back here. This looks like a company that was in shambles. Usually these reverse splits are in shambles, so... Means the companies need some help, but this company has a product being streamlined to market through the FDA, so they're literally about to get their FDA approval any freaking day. Any day. They're phase three right now, but any day they're going to get FDA approved, so that's going to make the stock go up, I think, for sure. You know, and this company has been respecting this trend line as well, so, you know, we could break down through this golden zone and touch this 170 here, maybe 165, something like that, but, you know, if you get in this stock under $2, I think you're going to be happy in a year from now. Maybe less. I'm not gonna stream for too much longer, guys. I got about another 30 minutes in me, and then we're gonna call it a day. I just wanted to get on here for a little bit and talk to you guys. I've already been doing this an hour and a half. Holy crap. Time flies on this thing, man. Time flies. Let me read this letter to the shareholders, guys. This was released back in February by Citius Pharmaceuticals. Dear fellow shareholders, Citius Pharmaceuticals Inc. Company has successfully traversed 2020 following what was a challenging year for so many. Thankfully, all of our employees and their loved ones have been able to avoid COVID-19 infections as we implemented various measures to keep our employees and visitors safe and virus-free. As for our business, we have continued to make solid progress since our last shareholder update in October 2020. We began 2021 with great enthusiasm and are building already what we expect to be a seminal year for advancing three of our product platforms in the clinic, all right? Guys, they have three products. They have the Halo Lido, they have the Amino Lock, and they have, what's the other one called? Oh, come on, where are you at? The Amino Wrap, that's right. So they have three flagship products, but this Amino Lock is their cash cow right here. This is the one that's gonna, that they're banking on. All right, this is the one that's phase three, about to get streamlined through the FDA, and they're going to have FDA approval here pretty shortly. Probably get some sales going by the end of this year, honestly. So that's really big. That's really, really big. It could. Yeah, the FDA approval could, but you know, this company is being streamlined through the FDA. So the FDA approval could happen by the end, before the end, the year's up, or it could happen early in the next year, but they did say that they're expecting sales by the end of this year or early into next year, Q1. So I don't know. I mean, we'll see what happens, but it looks very promising, you know, and their product is very, very unique. They have a patent that secures the product for like 12 years or something like that. So nobody can compete with them, really. There's just no room to compete.
Yeah, I mean, they can't lie, though. They can't lie. They do have that patent. And I'm with you. I mean, like I said, I don't trust companies as far as I can throw them, but, you know, everything that they're doing looks like they're on track to have their share price go up. It looks like the stock's going to go up. Chart-wise, DD-wise, you know, it all looks super solid, guys. And I don't invest, you know, lightly. Like, I'm not one of those people that just puts my money in something because somebody told me to, all right? I do a lot of research. And, you know, I don't know. I have confidence in my analysis and, you know, my research. So if I put money in a stock, it's because I actually believe in the technology of the product. Like, that's first and foremost. If I don't believe in the product, I'm not going to invest my money in it. That's why I didn't put my money in GME, guys. All right. Yeah, I could have made some money. I could have made a lot of money, but I don't believe in GameStop. I don't think GameStop, I think that company's crap, to be honest with you. I think they're total trash. It's a trash company. It didn't used to be, but it is now. You can't compete when everything's digital, all right? You just can't. GameStop is done. That company is completely done. They have no future value, and everyone's just waiting for a squeeze. So if I don't believe in a company, what they're doing, their product, their technology, I'm not going to put my money in it, all right? AMC is different because I think AMC in the long term, if they reopen, they could bounce back and have a profitable company, okay? The movie experience is not going to go away. Everybody loves going to the freaking movies, watching the movies inside the big screen, the big Dolby digital surround sound. Everybody loves that. That's never going anywhere. I truly believe that. So AMC is different, but GME is trash. The company's dead. It really is. In my opinion. So, I mean, I don't want to sit here in bag hole waiting for a squeeze. I want to put my money in something that I know is going to go up organically and naturally and doesn't even need a squeeze to go up. It's possible. It's possible. I mean, if Ryan Cohen can turn it around and, you know, figure out a way to streamline his business model, then okay. I mean, let's see it. But I can't imagine what he could possibly do. I mean, who can he really compete with at this point? I mean, you have PS Plus. You got all these. I mean, they're just cornering the market, guys. Why would you go to GameStop? Why would you ever go to GameStop to do anything? I sat there for a while and I was trying to figure out why would I ever, even if GameStop made things digital, why would I do it? I can go straight to the PlayStation store on my PlayStation and freaking buy something right now on PlayStation and get a discount for being a PlayStation Plus member. Why would I ever go to GameStop? There's just not a freaking reason. I can't think of one reason other than nostalgia why I would go through GameStop. You know, I just can't think of one. I can't. If you guys can think of one, put it in the chat. I cannot think of one, personally. I can't think of a reason anybody would ever use GameStop other than the fact that they use it as a child and they miss it. Like, I can't think of one. Same thing with Blockbuster. I mean, Blockbuster was so freaking lit on Friday nights when I was a kid, guys. You have no idea. Well, you probably do have an idea. Blockbuster was a freaking hit. All right, that place was lit as crap on Friday on the weekends, all right? And it was a great, great experience going there and picking up physical copies, but there's no room for it in today's market. There's just not. That's why they're not around anymore. That's why they literally just, they're just done. So GameStop's the same way. There's no real reason. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I have not, the last physical, and I'm a big gamer, guys. Okay, I'm a big gamer. The last physical copy of a game that I bought was Red Dead Redemption 2, all right? And that was, you know, over a year and a half ago, all right? That was the last physical copy I bought, and I bought it from Walmart. I didn't buy it from GameStop. So I can't tell. I mean, every game I bought since then has been just a digital download. So, and there's not a reason for me to go through GameStop, you know? There's just not a reason. I don't know how they can survive. So like I said, guys, if I don't believe in a company, the technology, I'm not just going to sit here and bag hold and you know, hope for a squeeze. To me, that's a bad investment. Yes, you can make a lot of money if it actually squeezes. Yes, you could. I mean, yes, you could. But do you really want to have all your money tied up waiting for that? It just seems, I mean, unless you got in at like $40, it just doesn't seem worth it to me. I mean, I would never in a million freaking years put my money in GameStop right now. I just wouldn't. That would just be, I feel like that would be such a bad move. And I just personally wouldn't do it. I mean, Jermarcus, I totally feel what you're saying. I mean, you're playing devil's advocate, and I completely respect it. You know what I mean? And they could. But I'm not going to sit here and bag hold, you know, waiting for it. It's too risky. The stock is just, the company is in the crapper. And I think that just, you know, I don't believe in the company. So, like I said, for me personally, I don't put my money in something I don't believe in. And, you know, what I believe in might be different than what you believe in, and that's completely fine. I'm not hating on anybody in GameStop. I just think that, you know, if you're going to put your money in something, hopefully it has some value other than, oh, my God, everyone on Reddit saying it's going to squeeze. So let me just put all my life savings in it and hope that they're right. That's a bad move. That's a bad move, in my opinion. So unless there's some actual value, I'm not gonna touch a stock. I'm just not. That's just me. You know, a lot of people trade different. That's just me, man. If you guys have any questions or anything, I'd be glad to answer them now. I got about 20 more minutes left, guys. I'm gonna call it a day at the 2 hour mark. About 25 minutes. Yeah, put it in MVIS. Fact, guys. I want to thank you guys for being here with me this morning. I appreciate it. Really appreciate you guys. You guys are awesome. I'm seeing the same names every day. Thank you guys for just hopping in here. I know you guys got lives. You got other stuff to do besides listening to my crazy ass talk, but you know what? We do it every day, basically, and I enjoy it. I have a good time in here. Joey Garcia says, is this the last time our price will be at this price? I mean, I would imagine, man. I mean, for the life of me, I can't, you know, from a guy, like I said, I am super big into technical analysis, price action, and I cannot for the life of me imagine how we will break this trend line. I just can't. I think 1010 was the literal bottom. It just doesn't make any sense to me how we would break the trend line. It just doesn't. Now, could we come down a little lower? Yeah, we could, because like technically, like I said, if I want to tighten this trend line up, okay, and I'm going to do it for you guys live here, because I might as well. If I want to tighten this trend line up here like this, and then kind of just throw it in here and, you know, really get it tight. Let me try it right here. And really get, and a lot of the times these trend lines, they do get broken under, they do get faked out. That happens often. So I'm going to go ahead and call this a fake out. And you can see it right here. I'm going to put it like right here, okay? So this is where I'm going to say the trend line, pretty much like kind of like right about there. All right? And so right at that blue line. So if I do it like that this way, you can see. All right, we had these fake outs here. This happens a lot in trend lines, all right? They did close below it on this hourly chart, but like I said, these fake outs happen all the time. So this is still just a trend line touch to me, all right? But you can see this trend line's super respected, and I don't see how in the world we would break below this trend line. Now, could we come down and do what it did here and come down, you know, what is this? This trend line was at 729. This was at 684. So could we have like a, you know, 30 to 50 cent variance here under the trend line? Yes, we could come down here and maybe be at like 1240, something like that, and then go back up. But I don't think we're ever going to really go back down to this like right here. I just don't see it happening. This company is only going up. There's not a reason for it to go down there. So no, I don't think that it's just going to go down like that. So I think this is probably the last time you're going to see this area. Yeah, I do. Lori, you're never going to hear that. Just so you know, you're never going to hear that. I'll address it really quick. I did nothing wrong, nothing illegal, but the backlash was crazy. You know, Reddit is led by some cult leader on some Microvision cult leader, and they just follow whatever he says. So you're never going to hear that again, and mainly just because I don't want to hear any crap about it. That's just the main reason. My ego wants me to put it up and tell everybody to piss off because I didn't do anything wrong, but you know, we're not going to talk about it because I just don't want to deal with it anymore. He said, oh, honey, you're taking a bath? Okay, I jump on to watch TMJ. Nice. Somebody made fun of that name. Somebody said TMJ. What's the jaw? Is it like the jaw condition? TMJ? Is that what was it? Oh, man, what's it called? I gotta look it up. Yeah, it's like a jaw disorder.
funny. I want to spend $42K on Mavis. Do it, man. Do it. It might be a good time to do it, man. I don't think you're ever going to get this chance again. I really don't. I mean, the only time I've been wrong about Microvision is when the stock market crashed. And I can't predict that, right? You can't predict that crap. But, I mean, I don't know. If there was ever a time to put 42K in, it's probably right friggin' now. And if it's not now, it's back at this trend line again. But, guys, I don't think you're ever going to get a chance like this again. I just really don't. April's coming up. There's like 6 days until April. One second, guys. I swear I keep hearing something scratching on my door, but I guess there's nothing there. Right now is a good time. It is. I just, like I said, as far as the my knowledge on price action goes, I don't think you're ever going to see this number again. I just don't. And mainly because April's coming up. So it's like, we already know what's going to happen in April. The share price is going to pop off. We already know that. So we just got to have diamond hands, guys. Throw some diamonds in the chat. Diamonds for all you diamond holding geniuses. Put some diamonds up in that chat. Because Microvision is going to the moon. It really is. Let me put my own diamonds. I'll put my own diamonds up in here. Oh, it didn't let me search for it. Oh, there we go. Put my own diamonds up in here. Oh, man. It doesn't let me put diamonds. Where's the diamond at? What the heck? Where y'all finding that? What the heck? How come I can't find the diamond? Oh, man. When I type in diamond, this is all that comes up. Y'all get the good diamond. I don't get the good diamond. Well, no, because there's a search thing right here. You can type like what emoji you want to search for. I was putting it right here. Why doesn't it show up on mine? That sucks. I swear I found it before. Like, where is this thing? Now I just gotta find it just to prove that it's to myself that it's here. I am not on my phone. I'm on the computer. Can you guys see? Yeah, you can see this window. You guys can definitely see this window. What the heck? There it is. There we go. What the heck? Oh, it's called a gemstone. That's why. It's called gemstone. That's stupid. There we go. So now I know. I gotta search gemstone and it pops up. All right, cool. Diamond hands. Diamond freaking hands. Yeah, guys, I don't think we're gonna break below this trend line. I don't think it's possible. It's possible, but is it likely? No, it's not. And this is another deal, guys. I want you guys to see this. So right now we're consolidating here and here. If you look left, there's no action up in here. It came straight through it, went straight through it. Here, there's none. It went straight through it. I hope you guys see this because I'm trying. I don't want to be a teacher or anything like that, but I want you guys to know that I know price action, all right? And this is telling me right here in this whole move, price does not like this area. It just doesn't. You can see it for your own eyes. Where do you see action in this area? There's none. Even over here where the candles are, it shot straight through this zone, straight through it. And then it tested here and bounced off it, came straight through with momentum, came straight back up with momentum, bounced off it. There's no action in this area. Price does not want to be in here. All right. And it's not going to go down because why would it? There's a trend line right here, a very respected trend line. So there's a super respected trend line. It's in an area where it doesn't want to be. I am saying it's bullish as
It's BAFF, all right, guys? It's bullish as F. Especially right now in this zone. I know Price doesn't want to be in here, so. MVIS needs to blow up. James needs a new everything. Nah, my phone's dope, man. I got a, what is this, a Note 20 Plus or Note 20 Ultra? This phone's good. I like this phone. I do need a new setup, man. I need to go ahead and get me a new rig for trading. I just do. This Alienware laptop is just not cutting it. It's just not cutting it. Hopefully, you know, when I can get to a point where I can monetize this channel, maybe I can make a couple extra bucks, offset some of the costs, because I don't want to get some crappy setup. Like, if I'm going to get something, it's going to be something sick. So, I don't know how many people would actually use Super Chat in my comments, but hey, any dollar that would help me get a new setup would be appreciated. And I could just do it. I could just buy it right now. I'm just lazy, and they don't have the setup I want. They don't have the graphics card that I want in stock right now, so I'm kind of just waiting for that to come in, and it's just, there's just a whole bunch to it. Joey says, hey James, let's throw a party at Vegas when we get bought out. I'm down, dude. I'm so down. You have no idea. I am so freaking down for that. Flights are going to be cheap. I am so down for that, man. Let me know. I'll tell you what, if we're in Vegas, all the drinks are on me, okay? That means I don't have to spend a dollar because drinks are free in Vegas. I don't know if you guys caught that little joke. That was lame. I know. That was lame. But I do have to tip the waitress, so it's still going to cost me a little bit of money. Oh my God. Oh, yes, it is. The drinks are 100% free. The drinks are free for sure. Guys, I've been in here almost 2 hours. Yeah, the tips. Yeah, that's what I was saying. I can't really predict that, Joey, because I'm not convinced that they're just going to get bought out. I'm not convinced at this point that they're just going to get bought out, so. I play golf every once in a while. I'm not super into it. My grandpa was super into golf. He tried to get me into it, but I never really, I don't play too often. But I mean, that doesn't say, I've been wanting to play golf recently, actually. I've been thinking about it. Thinking about buying a set and just, you know, just kind of just maybe getting back into it. It's been a minute since I played golf. But, like I said, Joey, I don't know. It's hard to really say because I don't know how they're gonna, not really sure how they're going to move forward with the company. I mean, if they're going to get completely bought out, if they're going to sell verticals, it's just hard to say, man. It's just hard to say. Guys, I'm going to shut the stream off in 3 minutes. I'm going to shut it off at 11:10. So if you guys got anything to say, you want to ask any questions real quick, feel free to do that. The viewers are dropping off and I'm kind of over it. So it's been almost 2 hours. I wasn't even going to do anything this weekend, so. Yeah, Joey, I just don't know, man. It just depends on the direction they go with the company. It's really just up in the air. We know that they're going to do something some way, so I don't know. We're going to have to just wait and see what they do, man. I wish I could tell you something. It's just I would just be speculating, you know? It would be complete speculation. So, but I think if I had to just throw a number on it, and if a company was going to buy them out, I would say anywhere between 12 and 16 billion, something like that. I think 20 billions. I don't know. I don't want to be a pessimist, and I don't want to be an overachiever either, or too optimistic, but I think 12 to 16 billion would probably be something that they would, if they just sold the company as one, I think anywhere from 12 to 16. Now, if they sell it by the vertical, which, like I said, it's going to be worth a lot more. It's going to be worth a lot more. Like a freaking lot more. Like maybe like 30 billion. They have 6 verticals. Each vertical has the potential to spawn a $1 trillion market. So, I mean, if they sell it by the vertical, yeah, man, I mean, 30 billion. Really, like, seriously. I mean, they just really do. So. What's up, Kiwi? You're coming in right at the end of it, man. I'm about to get off here. I'm about to hop off of here. John Wells, what's up, buddy? Thank you guys for joining me today. I had a good time. I was going to do a little bit more DD on this, but I don't know. I kind of fell off. Guys, check out CTXR. I'm going to invest in this company, I think, this week. They have the Mino Lock. This is their flagship cash cow product. It treats catheter-related bloodstream infections. It doesn't, and they don't really have any competition. So this is a good stock to be in right now. The chart looks good. Looks like we're going to make our way back up to the top of this golden zone, I'm assuming. So it would be a good time to get in. If you're under $2 entry, that's a good entry point for the stock. Once we get bought out, hey, I mean, that's up to you, man. Whatever they're going to do, I don't know if they're going to do a straight cash. They're going to do a share/cash. I don't know. These questions are very hard to answer because it's complete speculation, but I don't know. I'm not really willing to sell before 100, you know, before $100. So at the $90-$110 range, I'm going to have to make a decision. So do I want to diamond hand this thing to 180 or do I want to take my money? So it's going to be hard. It's going to be hard. Hey, you too, Jamarcus. I hope you're a sub, man. I hope to catch you back here on Monday. If you're not a sub, well, I don't know whatever I can do to get you to be a sub, but I do appreciate you being in here and listening to me talk for the past hour and a half, 2 hours. It's been good times. All right, guys, that's going to do it. Can we get some rockets? We got to close this out with some energy. Let's get the rockets flowing. I know I need to type gemstone now. Let's get these rockets and diamonds flowing. All this crap. As you already know what Microvision is going to do. We're going to the moon for sure. Appreciate that. And you guys know what it is. Microvision is the truth. This is the stock that we all love. And there's a lot to love about it. I love this stock, guys. And I would never do anything to jeopardize it. Just know that, okay? No matter what you read about me, no matter what you hear, these people are following a cult and they don't know what they're talking about, all right? I would never do anything disrespectful to anybody in that company, let alone anybody in real life. So I love you guys. Thank you guys for sticking around. Depth put toilets and shit. That's great. You guys are something else, man. Oh yeah, let me put the Discord link in here one more time. Guys, get up in this Discord because it's free for now. I don't know what I'm gonna do with the Discord, but it's free, and you guys can get in here and meet some other traders, and spend some time. We're always in there talking like 24/7. Usually, there's somebody in there talking about Microvision. So if you like Microvision, and you like talking about stocks, get up in the Discord, please, because that's a good place to be. Oh man. I messed it up. There we go. Oh, God, I'm typing in the wrong spot. That's why. There we go. That is the Discord. Love you guys, too. Appreciate you. Thank you so much, Joey. You're awesome, man. Thank you so much. That's the Discord link, guys. Please get in there. Just hang out in there. You know, Tyler Andrews, what's up, man? You got it? There you go, buddy. Oh, my God. I keep typing in the wrong place. There you go. But yeah, man, hang out in Discord with us. Talk about Microvision. There's a lot of cool people in there. And guys, for sure I'm not getting on tomorrow, all right? I'm going to take a day off. I got to. I got a tournament tomorrow, so I'm going to get rested for that. I might go play some cards tonight. We'll see. But I'm definitely going to be on Monday at the Bell, hopefully, if not shortly after. And I hope to see you guys on Monday. I really do. Because we're going to follow this freaking stock to the moon. We're going to follow this stock all the way to the moon. And price does not want to be in this area. So I imagine we're going to bounce off this trend line, get up out of this freaking little consolidation zone, and we're going to be up in the $15 range, hopefully by Tuesday. That's what I think. Maybe Monday. So, guys, have a great weekend. Have a great Saturday. I'll see you guys on Monday, okay? Peace and love. Peace out, guys. Okay, I'm really ending it now. Have a good weekend, guys. Trade Mode James signing out. Bye-bye.